everybody. I'm April Crosley, and I'm a real estate investor in Berks County, Pennsylvania. And today we're going to walk through a house that we just finished flipping. It was on the market and it's under contract to sell. And we're going to show you everything that we did with the property. So if you like videos like that, click like, subscribe to our channel so you don't miss our next episode. And next week we're going to do Deal or Dud, where we'll give you the whole rundown of all the numbers on the rehab project and what kind of profit we made. So let's go inside. Okay, so welcome to the inside of what I have dubbed as the Roach House. And I'll tell you guys why in a couple of minutes. So this is a house that we just got done flipping, and people always ask me, how did you find this property? That's the number one thing. Okay, I lied. That's the number two thing. The number one thing everyone wants to know is, how do you find money, right? And the number two thing is, how do you find the deals? So how we find this deal, it was actually referred to me by someone that trusts me and knows that I buy houses in Berks County because we've been doing it for a long time. We buy from sellers in pretty sad situations, and you'll find that as you get into real estate investing. So you definitely have to have a little bit of empathy and be sensitive to be in this business, which most people don't realize. But in this case, there was a little old lady living here that had no family. Her husband had passed away several years ago. She couldn't take care of the house anymore. And she couldn't really take care of herself. It got to the point that she had caregivers coming into the home to help take care of her, and she really needed to sell. When I came to walk through the house and to meet her, the first thing she said to me was, I have to go to a facility and I have $10 in my pocket. So she had no money to pay for care, but she had her house and she needed to sell. She was going to a facility within a week. So she needed the property to sell really quickly. So two factors for why she sold it to me as a real estate investor. One, speed. We can close within a week or two, which is what she needed so that she could get money from the house. Number two, the kitchen, which I'm going to take you into in a few minutes, was infested with cockroaches. She really had limited ability to move around and take care of things. So she would cook and she would eat, but she would leave food kind of all over the kitchen. So even though it's a single house and it's not attached to anyone else, and she didn't really have garbage per se building up, but she had just food, open containers of food out. We had a really bad cockroach infestation, which we knew there were cockroaches when we bought it, but the infestation was a lot worse than we thought. And I'll tell you about that when we get into the kitchen. So I'll walk you through and show you a little bit about what we did. This whole living room area in here was paneling, wall to wall paneling. So if you guys want to follow before and after pictures of properties, we have a Facebook page, Crosley Properties LLC, and also We Buy Houses Berks County, that you can check out our before and after pictures. But the whole house was paneling. For those of you who don't know what paneling is, it's this really dated wood looking wall. It's hideous, hideous. Orange carpet everywhere, really was purchased in the 1950s and hadn't been updated since the 1950s. So it needed everything, light fixtures, doors. We ripped out all the paneling. We put drywall in the whole house. The whole house, wall to wall, was paneling. So it all had to be ripped out and the whole house had to be drywalled. New light fixtures, new flooring, new windows in the living room. Come on, I'll take you into the kitchen. We completely gutted the kitchen. Because it was infested with cockroaches, we thought if we strip out the drywall, get the house down to the studs, and then we do a cockroach treatment, maybe two, we will be totally free of cockroaches. We did six roach treatments. So when they say that those suckers don't die, they don't die. Cockroaches don't. They're dead now, and we haven't seen any, but it takes a long time for those suckers to die. So if you buy a house with a cockroach infestation, even if you strip it down to the studs, six cockroach treatments is what it took. I mean, they were pulling off like light switch covers, because we always change out all the light switch covers, and like we're finding cockroaches that were crawling out. It was super gross, and yet another reason why I do not lift a finger and work on any of the houses. So yeah, I'm too pretty for that. So this is the kitchen. We completely gutted it. I have to tell you, in A lot of people are gonna say, the kitchen's so small. It is really small. You see this door here? This goes to the basement, okay? So we have a living room, basement steps, and a kitchen. You can't knock down a wall where there's basement steps and expand the kitchen. And with the rehab costs we were working with, because we wanted to get her as much money as we could to go to the nursing home, we weren't gonna like rearrange the whole layout of the house. So we kept the kitchen small, we just opened it up a little bit to make it a little bit bigger. So originally, the whole sink and countertop was behind this door. So you'd open the door into the sink. It was really super awkward. And this goes out to the backyard. So we completely ripped out everything, including drywall, and just put a whole new kitchen back in. And I can show you guys the bedrooms and the bathroom, which isn't exciting. We pretty much just ripped out everything as well in the bedrooms and the bathrooms. But this place was crawling with cockroaches. My contractors would call me and say, I know you had two cockroach treatments done, but we went in there and all my contractors have kids and they're like, we don't want to take roaches home to our kids and we're still seeing roaches. And they call me and they come back and say, we're still seeing roaches. And I was like, oh my gosh, how can we still be seeing roaches? But they were, so thank heavens, they're done now. But so from the living room, we also completely gutted the bathroom, which is right behind me. We actually, just a little rehab trick for you in case you don't know, we didn't rip out the tub. We rarely to never rip out bathtubs unless they're in really poor condition or the floor underneath them is rotted out or something. But my contractor glazes the tub, and there's companies out there that just do tub glazing, and it's a lot cheaper than ripping out the entire tub. So we repainted the whole bathroom, did new toilet, new sink, we did tile tub surround and glazed the tub, but we didn't rip the tub out, so it saves a lot of time, and glazing so much cheaper, so much easier, so. And then we can check out the bedroom, one of the bedrooms out of three. And we, in the bedroom, there's not too much to show. This is the smallest of the bedrooms. Just something I want to tell you, in here, there was like a built-in closet, which is great. But when you have a built-in closet, something we didn't, I don't know why we didn't take this into account or realize it, but when we ripped out the built-in closet to make the bedroom a little bit bigger, because you can tell it's already really small and there's no closet in here. When we ripped out the closet, there was like a hole in the floor. So our carpet guy came to put carpet in and he was like, you first have to fix the floor because there was like a huge divot where the built-in closet was. So that was something we had to have our contractor come in and fix after the fact. But as far as like the bedroom doors, we kept the original bedroom doors and just painted them, and the hardware on them is old. It's like the glass doorknobs, and we keep them too because they look nice. They're like old and sturdy and really nice doorknobs. So we just clean them up and keep all that stuff. But the light fixtures we changed out because they were hideous, hideously old before we started rehabbing it. So this door here off the living room leads to the third bedroom, or what we made the third bedroom. So when we purchased the home, there was a small bedroom, a bigger master bedroom, and the second floor, this is a Cape Cod house, was used just for storage. Again, had paneling everywhere. They loved paneling back then. Blech. Don't ever tell me it's coming back in style. It'll never come back in style. So we ripped out all the paneling up there, painted it, and we put carpet on the second floor and made that into a third bedroom, which made the house more desirable. There was already heat up there, a little electric heater, but sometimes we'll renovate the second floor and we'll have to install electric baseboard heat so that it can be utilized as a bedroom. But if you have a two bedroom and you have second floor space, it's a great way to get more money out of the house by making it into a third bedroom. Even if you have to add heat, a third bedroom home is usually more desirable than a two bedroom home. So on the outside of the house, just some things to take into consideration. When we did this rehab project, there's really tall, huge trees everywhere. In the backyard, out front, there's a huge tree. the trees were laying on the house, and a lot of rehabbers miss that cost. You have to have those trees trimmed back, because when someone comes through to do a home inspection or an appraisal, they're gonna call you out on it. They're gonna say, the tree has to be trimmed back. You can't have tree branches laying on the house. And a lot of times when houses are older and they're let go and people aren't maintaining them, you have tree branches that lay on the house, you have landscaping that's overgrown, and that was the case with this property. Just tons of overgrown bushes, tons of overgrown trees laying on top of the house, so we had to cut all that back, which was a pretty big expense, but something we definitely accounted for. When you run your comps on your properties, don't forget to check into parking. On this property, it looks like there's a garage that goes with the property, but it's not our garage. So there's no off-street parking. You have a little yard, but you have no garage, no parking pad, no nothing. So when you're comparing houses in the neighborhood and you're running your comps, it's really important that you're comparing apples to apples, houses that don't have garages and don't have off-street parking when you're coming up with your value, because you want your ARV to be on point. Because if it's not on point, that's when you risk losing money. All right, guys, that concludes our walkthrough of the Roach House Rehab Project. Thanks for joining us. If you enjoyed the video, give us a like and subscribe. That way you'll get updates, because we're gonna do a deal or dud video on the Roach House, which is gonna show you the exact breakdown of numbers, what we bought it for, what our rehab costs were, and what our profit is on the property. So if you like this video, you can find out more about us at www.lazygirlrei.com. You can also follow us on Facebook, Lazy Girl Real Estate Investing, and you can like us on Instagram, April Crosley.